Hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Donkey Kong 64. In this episode, we're going to be going around more of the Donkey Kong Islands, picking up all the golden bananas and stuff that we missed or just bypassed when we were initially doing each of these levels. We're going to be first stopping off here in Jungle Japes' lobby. You can see there's a chunky boulder right here that we can go ahead and pick up right now. There are a few things to do in each lobby, usually with varying Kongs. Like, for instance, we have to have Chunky to be able to lift this boulder up, but it's actually a Lanky Pad, so we're gonna have to get Lanky out instead, and use him to figure out whatever it is this pad does. Most of the times, these are just golden bananas, but occasionally they'll make other things appear that are gonna be of use to us. This one's just an easy golden banana. Thanks, Squawks! Alright, so three golden bananas for Lanky. Another thing that is also on the overworld that we haven't really touched on yet is the fact that there is a Kasplat for every Kong out here. There's five blueprints here, just like there are inside of the levels themselves. So, let's go on and head up to Angry Aztec's lobby and see what we've got to do in there. Okay, so it looks like we've got some things here to do with Diddy, since those are Chimpy Charge gongs there. Let's go ahead and do that. And I've mentioned a couple of times in the past that there are several points in this game where you have to use multiple Kongs to do multiple things. Well, this level is, well, not necessarily this level, but the overworld is one of the spots in the game where it almost necessitates you using different Kongs to do different things to be able to get golden bananas. So, like, you have Diddy, for instance, there using his gongs to cause the, banana barrel to rise, but the only one of the Kongs who can actually reach the banana barrel is Tiny. She has to stand on this rail here and use her ponytail twirl to fly out to get it. I said she has to stand on the rail here and ponytail twirl to fly out and get it. Darn it. Alright, never mind. Let's just do this real quick. Something else we gotta do with Tiny first, and then I think it's actually for Chunky in there? I'm not sure. Let me take a look. Yep, for Chunky. Let's go ahead and get that banana barrel, though, while we still got Tiny out here. I don't know, can you do it from this corner of the room? I don't think so, that looks like a little too far for me, to me. Come on, there we go. There we go, let's see what minigame we've got, shall we? Big Bug Bash, of course. They couldn't make it an easy one. Thankfully, this isn't the hardest version of this game that we have. The one in Creepy Castle is obviously harder, but just something to keep in mind, if you do find minigames out here on DK Isles, they're not going to be easy. They're going to be, like, usually the second hardest version of each game. I'm doing really badly. There we go. Maybe it's because I'm expecting a little bit of lag and I'm not getting it. Gotcha! Oh, come on, you little cheater. Oh, man. Of course. It can never be easy. It can never be easy.
Welcome to bonus stage.
Yeah, like I said, I might be expecting a bit of it. I might be a little bit off for the next couple of episodes as I get used to this new capture software. I'm recording using the same exact technique as before, only I'm using an upgraded software and upgraded capture card. So it should give you quite a bit better quality video-wise Hopefully it will, anyway. And also, I'll be able to edit it, the episodes themselves quite a bit better. There we go! See? See? Why could I never get that game on the first try? The golden banana comes on down. So we've got three golden bananas with three out of five Kongs already. We've already made a bunch of progress here on the DK Isles, but let me go ahead. I think I know what that chunky thing actually does, and it's not of any use to us, but we might as well do it just to show off what it actually does. Those zingers actually don't fire grenades at you. They'll just swoop down at you like the ones in Jungle Japes do. Don't ask me why. Ah, there we go. Bad depth perception. For the loss. Yep, all that stamping on the Switch does is make a wrinkly Kong thing appear out here in the front in the lobby, which this is something that I really didn't explain very much. In each lobby, there's five doors, one for each Kong. Each one opens to show you the ghost of Wrinkly Kong, Cranky's wife, and each one of those gives you a hint for a golden banana that you can find in each level for one Kong. Each hint is only You only get the same hint in each lobby, so she gives you hints where to find five golden bananas, one for each Kong. That's what I'm trying to say. Doing a very, very bad job of saying that, but whatever. Alright, so we're going to go a little bit out of order here, because we're going to go into Fungi Forest Lobby first, and then we're going to do Gloomy Galleons and then Frantic Factory, since those are closer together. Go ahead and end in here. Alright, so this, that Donkey Kong switch right there, all that does is cause this to rotate, which means you can get to the different wrinkly hints for all the different Kongs, but there's something else over here that it's going to be more of interest to us, I think. Yep, okay, see if on the ceiling there, there's a mushroom sliding around? Well, what we want to do is get out the Kong with the corresponding color, i.e. Diddy for red, Donkey for yellow, Tiny for purple, Lanky for blue, and Chunky for green. And then, I already forgotten what color that was. Nope, wrong one. It's Donkey's. And then shoot it with their shooters. Not a difficult task, considering the mushroom moves fairly slowly, and you can hit it. It's got a very generous hitbox, thankfully. Okay. Yeah, its movement is a little bit erratic, but I think it basically moves in a staggered figure eight pattern almost. So, or I might just be making it all up. You'll never know. Come on now. Okay, so Tiny is last. Okay. Do sinking the audio. See, it's gonna be the hard thing since I actually with my new capture card, there's actually a bit of lag in the recording, so the audio is just a bit behind the video, which means that. I'm gonna have a hard time syncing up a lot of the time where my audio and video are. You use the chunky pad to reveal a battle arena pad. Yes, there's actually a battle arena pad on the overworld. Forest Fracas. Of course, being able to do this with Chunky just makes it that much easier because Chunky actually has one of the most effective running attacks out of all the Kongs. It gives you very, very little forward momentum, and you can still turn just as sharply while you're doing it as normally. And he actually manages to stay in the air long enough during his aerial attack to be able to avoid the Kasplat's shockwaves, which means that you can, even though this is one of the hardest battle arenas to do in the game, it's actually very, very possible to do this without using your shockwave attack. Alright, come at me, bros. Chunky rules you. Easy stuff. Like I said, being able to use Chunky for that is almost as good as being able to use Lanky. So, yeah. Alright, and then there's one other thing to do in here. See that tiny switch up in the corner? We're going to want to get Tiny out and hit that. Because that is something that is pretty darn important. Not Golden Banana important, but still pretty darn important. Do-do-do! Say hello to Banana Fairy! Okay, now this Banana Fairy is actually, surprisingly enough, even though you find it on the overworld, one of the most skittish in the entire game. It is extremely, extremely annoying to try to take a picture of. Not only because it hides, it likes to dart around inside in the, between the rafters, making it really hard to get a picture of it on the far end of the room, but also because it goes literally everywhere in the room. And there's very, very little pattern to its movements. Okay, where'd it go? This is weird. That was really weird. I've never had that happen before. I never had the Banana Fairy just completely vanish like that. It must have been because I was over on the other side of the room. Hold still. Hold still and let me shoot you! She moves slow every once in a while, but not very, and I do believe this is one of the ones with a fixed pattern instead of flying around randomly, but it's still a very long pattern, and she's still extremely skittish while she's doing it. Yes! Got her! Yeah, that one can be frustrating to try to take a picture of, but not necessarily the most frustrating. There's going to be one later that's even worse, but for now, that's the worst we've got. Which, if that's the worst, you know, we don't have to worry about all that much. Again, no fall damage from using Ponytail Twirl. Awesome. Alright, there's Banana Port 3. Let's take this out here to the front, and then we'll go to Gloomy Galleon's lobby, and then we'll head over to Frantic Factories after we're finished. Okay. Swimming underwater is always faster than monkey paddling. Go ahead and head inside. So yeah, hopefully the video quality turns out better. I'm gonna be using a lot of almost the exact same techniques as before when it comes to compressing the video. I'm just gonna record it at a much higher bit rate and everything. So hopefully that'll lead to improvements in quality. So there's actually quite a few things to do in this lobby, this being one of them. There's a tiny barrel here, there's a pipe in the wall over there, and we gotta go and swim through it. This is actually one of the better known glitches in this game, is that you can actually get into that room, this looks like it's blocked off, you can actually get into that room with any of the Kongs by glitching through the wall, but it doesn't gain you anything because you can't collect the golden banana with any Kong but Tiny, so you really can't do anything of use in there. Might as well hit this switch, which I believe it just opens the pipe, and then we also want to pick up Chunky's blueprint while we're here. Do-do-do-do-do. Down you go. Alright, so that's Chunky's blueprint. He only has one golden banana left to find on the entire overworld, and then he's done with all of his collectibles out here. Just pretty impressive. We're making very good progress out here on the DK Isles. Okay, so now we want to do the exact same thing we did before. Ponytail twirl into the tiny barrel, swim over to the hole, and pick up a golden banana. Which will actually make Tiny's fourth, I believe, which means that just like Chunky, she only has one more thing to find out here, that being a blueprint. instead of a golden banana, but still. So you can switch back to regular Tiny to get that, I think, maybe not, because I don't know if there's a Tiny Barrel in here. No, there's not. So I don't think your Crystal Coconut count will run down while you're in this room, because otherwise, if it did, you get stuck, and then, well, there'd be no way out except to quit and restart the game. So they don't want to do that to you. So we're going to go ahead and swim out and head up to Frantic Factory's lobby. And... Come on now, Tiny. Cooperate with me. There we go. Alright. Go ahead and Banana Port 4 and take it up to Frantic Factory's lobby. Then we're gonna do Crystal Caves and Creepy Castle after that. I want to do Creepy Castles first, actually, because that's closer. Actually, there's one other thing that we can do here that's closer than even that. It's really close. Okay, so Tag Barrel right here. I believe we want to use Chunky to smash this box over here in the corner. There we go. It frees Tiny's Kasplat as well as another Banana Fairy. Yes, there's three Banana Fairies so far on the DK Isles. There's actually a total of four. So... Ow. Get off. There's four Banana Fairies on the DK Isles, even though there's just a regular amount of bananas and stuff for each Kong. That's not what I meant to do. Thankfully, though, this Banana Fairy is not nearly as skittish as the one in Fungi Forest Lobby, and we can take a picture of it. Yay! Alright, and you may notice that switch over there? That just takes you up to this balcony. What's up there? Let me show you. Switch over to DK, and roll on over. Alright. Seems like such a long time ago we were doing this level. Very third level in the game. So there's a couple of candy things for us to... There's a candy pad, a music pad. But there's also a couple of the Wrinkly Kong doors up here that you can only access after you've pulled that switch. Which, they make these little puzzles so that you can get to them, but really, I don't care. It's not like you ever need to see Wrinkly Kong, and there's Donkey's second banana on the overworld. He was the one, remember, he was the one that we got the first one with. So, yeah. The fact that we finally have his second is pretty good. Okay, and then, let me see. Oh yeah. We can go out and do something out here. You just follow the path back down DK Rule Isle a little bit. I'm going to show you guys something that I didn't show you before of what, remember I said that there was a Snides out here on the overworld, just like there's a Cranky's? Well, here's where it is. You have to use these conveniently placed vines to get across here and in here. And this is Snides. It's actually got some pretty nice music in here. Kind of jazzy. There's a Diddy Pad over here, which I believe leads to a bonus barrel. Yes, it does. And there's also another Battle Arena Pad under a boulder. So, two Battle Arena Pads. Wow. They're spoiling us. What do we got here? Batty Barrel Bandits! Alright. Four slots. Three rolls. Let's do this. Ah, too early. This minigame, like I said, it's a welcome break when you can do it. It's a welcome break from the more frustrating minigames of the end game. That's why I wanted to save this one to do it until now. Just because it's great to have... It's great to be able to do a minigame that doesn't want to... You know... It doesn't have it out for me, you know. That game is fun. It's simple, but it's fun. Let's go ahead and do this Battle Arena Pad over here in the corner, and then we'll leave. This is actually the Snides we're going to be coming to. after we've gotten all of the other blueprints on the overworld, because we do have to do Snides before we can get to the end. Bish Bash Brawl! Before we can get to the end level. Or at least, is it highly advisable? You can probably do it. You can go to the ending level before you go to Snides, but it's not advised. Because, quite frankly, it's suicide. Down you go. Chunky rules you. Easy stuff. I mean, even though Chunky is... I wouldn't say he's the best at this, Lanky is, but Chunky is pretty darn good. You know? It's because, like I said, his running attack is probably the best in the game for doing this. Lanky's is a close second. It doesn't help because it slows you down a little bit while you're walking, but it also has a much wider attack radius, so they kind of trade off. Alright, so we're done here. Let's go and head to, let me think. Let's do Creepy Castle's lobby since it's right here. Go ahead and swim. It is much faster to swim underwater than it is to monkey paddle. I think I've said it before. Go ahead and jump in here. So we just have the Creepy Castle lobby and the Crystal Caves lobby to do. I believe there is a Diddy thing to do around the back here. Let me check and see. I know there's something to... There's a couple of things to do with Diddy in this lobby. Oh, there's a donkey gate that actually leads to something with Diddy. Okay, so we need, and then I saw a chunky boulder, a boulder that Chunky can pick up over there. So let's do that first. We'll get the blueprint in a minute. Go ahead and head around here. This episode is taking a long time. I'm still like 22 minutes or so on my recording. Oh, why, you filthy? That wasn't nice. That wasn't nice at all. You know how not nice it was? Chunky Smash! We saw some really bad texture pop on that. Let me see if I can hit this guy with the boulder. Nope. Yeah, it looks like there's a Lanky pad there. I believe it leads... I want to say there's a bonus barrel up there. Yep. Which, I don't remember what it is, but I do remember not liking it. So... let's go ahead and do the blueprint first, and then we'll do Lanky's thing. Then we just gotta go to Crystal Cave's lobby, and we'll be done with this episode. Or almost done with this episode. There's still one other thing I wanted to do. Alright, so let's go get the dids. Diddy... okay, easiest way to get this guy. Fill his face with peanuts while you're over here, then jump across. Because otherwise he could very well knock you into the insta-death goop. Just like that Kasha did to us a little bit ago. So then we've got... oh, you probably just heard someone come down the stairs. Well, now we just got that Lanky pad to do, and we'll be done here. Alright, let's head over here. Pop. Whoops. Walked a little too far there. Okay, going up. Okay, and there's a dirt mound up here, too. Not that we need it at this point. Searchlight Seek. Okay, so this isn't so bad. I mean, it could be a pain if you're not very good at aiming, but... not too much trouble. Do-do-do-do-do. 10 clap traps, 60 seconds, one every 6 seconds, that's more than enough time. Especially if they spawn right on top of each other like these, then you can just spawn camp them. Where did you go? There you are. Gotcha. Okay, one more, two more, three more. Ah, you moved. Gotcha. Now where's that last one? There you are. Gotcha. See? First try. Not bad. Not bad. Not exactly a hard game anyway, so... might as well pick up this coin while we're here. And I just bugged the sound. I love doing that. Alright, so that's that. Let's head over to Crystal Cave's lobby. Alright, so here we are in Crystal Cave's lobby. Now, there are quite a few things that we need to do here with several different Kongs. First of all, you may notice the sheets of crystal, or ice, or whatever they are, on the sides, just like they were in the levels themselves. You have to smash them with Chunky to be able to open them up. Now, there's also this switch here on the floor. All that does is open up Wrinkly Kong for all the different Kongs. It's with these crystals here on the wall. Each one covers a Wrinkly Kong door. So that's not going to be much use to you. Go ahead and get Donkey out and go into here, I believe. I think there should be... yep, there it is. Okay, there's a Donkey Barrel here. There's also a Lanky's Blueprint. You want to get to the Donkey Barrel and then just roll across the lobby into the other side where the lava is. And then just run across the lava to get the golden banana. Easy stuff. Again, as long as you have Strong Kong, not a hard banana to get. Let's go ahead and run across here. Okay, then let's get Lanky out and do that thing with him. And then that boulder you see in there is just to hold the switch down, so it's not really any use. You know, we could do that, I just don't see the point, considering I've made it a point this run through to not talk to Wrinkly Kong at all. Gotcha. Alright. That's that, and now let's, there's actually one more thing to do in this lobby that's not obvious when you first play through this, you know, first come up here, but there's actually a Diddy Barrel here inside the lobby. You might think, well, what's the use in that? You can't really fly anywhere. Yes, you can. There's a ledge that you can only access through using the Diddy Barrel. It's got Diddy's Wrinkly Kong door, as well as a Diddy pad. Or a Diddy music pad, I mean. Alright. And that brings down Diddy's fourth golden banana, which means that we've completed Diddy as well as, I believe, completing Lanky. So, we only have a couple of things left to collect. No, we still have a golden banana for Chunky and a golden banana for Donkey. And also Donkey's blueprint. So, we just have those things left to do, huh? Well... where could they be, though? We've already checked almost everywhere on the overworld. And we've gone into all of the lobbies. Well, I'll give you guys a hint. Endgame, my friends. We're in the endgame. Which means that in the next episode, we're going to be heading up there to the gullet of Kerule Island. And finding out what's in that lobby, as well as visiting Snides and seeing what he can do for us to help us on our quests. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time. Good night.